Mangroves are trees, forests, that are located in tropical wetlands, and they are distributed all over the Gulf of Mexico, from Florida to Brazil.
Mexico is among the four countries with the greatest cover of mangrove in the world. Mangroves are helpful to humans because they nourish coastal fisheries, they reduce flood impact, they promote connectivity with coastal ecosystems such as seagrasses and coral reefs, they filter water, and they're one of the most carbon-rich ecosystems.
Mangrove forest is disappearing due to the urban sprawl, agricultural and cattle raising, and pollution. So we decided to explore solutions to fix it and restore the mangrove in those coastal lagoons.
Our four projects are located in coastal lagoons in the Mexican Gulf states of Veracruz, Campeche, and Quintana Roo. Each of our sites presented different environmental problems. In our Alvarado Veracruz project, 4.5 acres were successfully reforested with 2,000 plants of red, white, and black mangrove using the chinampa or floating island technique. These floating islands basically have a structure made of iron, bamboo, or some other material and contain mud inside. And they help seedlings root with high survival rates. At the Tuxpan Veracruz project, 3 embankments where high voltage electrical towers are located interrupted water flow, making the remaining water hypersaline and killing off mangrove. Through our project, we expanded 5 channels through the northern embankment from about 20 to 40 feet in width. The resulting increase in natural water flow is allowing the regeneration of red and black mangrove in 50 acres. For the Petenes Campeche project, we supported restoring a 25-acre area, reforesting it with red and black mangrove, and digging 2 artificial channels to restore hydrology. At the Nichute Quintana Roo project, we removed an exotic species, Casuarina equisitifolia, from 3 acres. It shows how key changes, such as building channels to restore hydrology or removing an invasive species, can set in motion natural mangrove regeneration.
It's important for Mexico to keep them, not only because fisheries depends on them, because tourism depends on them, and because sea level rise and storms are threatening all the communities along the coast. So for us to keep them safe and restore them is a mandate. We need to work together, Cuba, Mexico, and United States. Having this opportunity and having this program help us and to show not only that we share the problem, but also that we can collaborate and we can have joint ventures, joint efforts, and joint results.
Congratulations to the Gulf of Mexico Foundation Mexico chapter, the first place winner of the 2017 Gulf Guardian Award in the binational category.